हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स। चैप्टर 9 इज शर्ट इन द मार्केट। दिस चैप्टर टेल्स अस द स्टोरी ऑफ ए शर्ट। इट बिगिंस विद द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कॉटन एंड एंड्स विद द सेल ऑफ द शर्ट। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कॉटन एंड देन द डिस्कशन विल एंड एट द सेल ऑफ द शर्ट। सो वी विल ट्राई टू नो अबाउट चेन ऑफ मार्केट लिंक्स। From the producer of cotton to the buyer of the shirt in the supermarket, because we are consumer and only know that is the shirt we need, spend money and buy the shirt. But how this shirt has came into existence, what buying and selling has taking the place, what is the chain, in the chain who are benefited, who are not, we shall find out in this chapter. Swapna, a small farmer in Karnal, Andhra Pradesh, grows cotton on her small piece of land. The balls of the cotton plant are ripe and some have already burst. Once the harvesting is done, cotton balls are collected. These are taken to the local trader, as the farmer had borrowed money from the trader to buy seeds, fertilizers, etc. for cultivation. Swapna had to sell her cotton to the trader instead of selling at the Karnal market, because at the beginning of the cropping season she had taken a loan of 2500 and a high interest rate to buy seeds, pesticides, fertilizers, etc. Also, she was made to promise that she would sell all her cotton to the trader only. Even though the market price is high, the trader buys it at a low price from the farmer. That's why Swapna earning from cotton cultivation is barely more than what she might have earned as a wage laborer. Next, the cloth market of Erode. The bi-weekly market of Erode in Tamil Nadu is one of the biggest cloth markets in the world. Cloth made by weavers from all over comes here for sale. Instructions about the type of cloth to be made is given in advance. The weavers get yarn from the merchants and supply them the cloth. It saves money of the weavers as they do not have to buy yarn. Likewise, the problem of selling the cloth is also taken care of. Since weavers do not know the price of the cloth, they are at a loss and get very small amount. The merchant distributes work among the weavers based on the orders he has received for cloth. And merchants supply cloth on order to garment manufacturer and exporter around the country. But weavers invest all their savings or borrow money at high interest rates to buy looms. Each loom costs ₹20,000. So a small weaver with two looms has to invest ₹40,000. The work on these looms cannot be done alone. The weaver and another adult member of his family work up to 12 hours a day to produce cloth. For all this work, they earn about only ₹3,500 per month. The arrangement between the merchant and the weavers is an example of putting out system, whereby the merchant supplies the raw material and receives the finished product. Next, the garment exporting factory near Delhi. Erode merchants sent the cloth to garment export center in Delhi. The garment exporting factory will use the cloth to make shirts. The shirts will be exported to foreign buyers. It means the garments factory makes shirt to be sold to the chain of business from the US and Europe, and they set standard of quality and time. These large stores of business strictly on their own terms, and factory owners try to get maximum work done in lowest possible time and money. The Impax garment factory has 70 workers. Most of them are women. Most of these workers are employed on a temporary basis. This means that whenever the employer feels that a worker is not needed, the worker can be asked to leave. Workers' wages are fixed according to their skills. The highest paid among the workers are the tailor, who get about ₹3,000 per month. Women are employed as helpers for thread cutting, buttoning, ironing, and packaging. These jobs have the lowest wages. So workers are employed on a temporary basis, means they can be asked to leave any time when not needed. They have pressure to produce quality products in limited time. They have to do hard work for long hours. The workers don't get a fair deal and get low salary. They also don't have respect for the work they do. Next, the shirt in the US. The shirts sent from garment export centers are sold in dollars in the US. The shirts sold at rupees 200 by the garment export centers sell at rupees 1200 in the US. Thus, a chain of markets links the producers of cotton to the buyers at the supermarket. Point: market and equality. The foreign business person made huge profit in the market. The garment exporter made only moderate profits. The merchants or traders have earned more, but it is still much less than the exporter. But the small cotton farmer and the weaver at Erode did not get a fair price in the market for what they produced. On one hand, the market offers people opportunities for work and to be able to sell things that they grow or produce. On the other hand, poor people have no option but to depend on the rich. Poor are exploited in the market. Poor individuals have no choice, however, to rely upon the rich for sale of their products. So poor are misused in the market. That's why laws should be made to protect the interest of weavers and small farmers. Students, after watching the video clip, thoroughly read the chapter.